Good morning. Today we're going to talk about the lumbar. Definition. The lumbar vertebrae are the thickest segments of the spine. The more voluminous they are, the lower they are located in the lumbar spine. The intervertebral disc is thick, occupying a third of the vertebral body, which constitutes a mobility factor. They are characterized by the absence of the transverse foramen, part of the transverse processes, as well as the absence of articular facets on each side of the body of the vertebra. The lumbar vertebra are located in the lumbar region between the thoracic vertebra and the sacrum. Like all vertebra, the lumbar consists of a vertebral body and then an arch which supports the same process between the whole or spinal foramen is formed through which the spinal cord runs. First lumbar vertebra. Its upper articular processes present a concave articular facet back, and inside its lower articular process presents a convex articular facet, and it looks forward and outward like the T12, so it is very easy to confuse it with the T12 vertebra. Second lumbar vertebra. It can only be recognized if you have the previous vertebra. This is due to their thickening in size. They are considered to be from the same individual. Third vertebra. The L3 vertebra is a very powerful lever element in lumbar stability, which presents insertions of the psoas and diaphragm muscles, which are very important in osteopathic therapy due to their multiple articular and visceral relationships from a biomechanical point of view. The body's center of gravity is located around the first vertebra and is the center of lumbar lordosis. This gives it greater osteopathic relevance, since it will be an area of special interest in terms of mobility, both at the particular level of said vertebra and the lumbar segment as a whole. 4. Lumbar vertebra. Lumbar punctures are generally performed between the joint of L4 and L5 for the extraction of cerebrospinal fluid due to its easy palpation at its opening, allowing the needle to enter the subarachnoid space. Fifth lumbar vertebra presents its a particularity in the joint with the sacrum. This point is called a promontory. It presents a more open angle. This point is very important to measure the corresponding angle of inclination. It can be recognized, saying it from a sagittal plane, from the rest because its anterior height is greater than the posterior height, that is, the anterior length of the body arch is greater than the length of the posterior arch of the body. So, it is co-coined. General characteristics of the lumbar vertebra. The upper and lower surface are flat or slightly concave behind the are concave and constricted on the front and sides. The vertebral foramina are considerably deeper in the lower vertebra. Two processes, they are called in costume for appendices. In the superarticular process, there is a bony mammalum called the mammillary process. The concave arrangement of the articular process allows greater movements at this level. In the upper lumbar region, they are taller than they are wide, while in the lower lumbar vertebra, they are wider than they are tall. Thank you for viewing.